Well, what you're looking at is what's left of a tanker truck. And part of the reason here, they, you know, they said it overturned. Well, coming off the exit ramp here, it's almost a 90-degree turn. You can see it goes right back behind the trees there, and you can see the freeway behind it. So almost a 90-degree turn coming over here. If you hit that too fast, that truck could roll, and possibly that's what happened here. Now, a couple bits of residual damage that happened here. John, take a look at that sign over there. This is how high the flames and the smoke were. This is the sign at the exit that was right in front of the Panda Express, which is also a little singed, but you can see that sign at one point looks like it was probably engulfed in flame. As we come down the street towards us, and we are looking towards the south right now, for those of you who are familiar with Atwater, we're just a couple of blocks away from the Walmart and the Super Target, which is north of that. So we're looking at the intersection here, and John is right on the McDonald's. So John, zoom in on the McDonald's, and we can see where all of the grass and shrubberies and the McDonald's has been charred right there. But here is where it could have been extreme trouble for this area. As John pulls out, you look down, that's a gas station. It's possible the truck was even heading for that gas station. Don't know for sure. But you can tell from the roadside that some of that fuel was burning along the road, just like it was burning McDonald's. So you had the potential of this gas station catching fire from this as well. As a matter of fact, had the truck caught fire just a block further to the west, it would have been right next door to this gas station.